A von Neumann model for a computer system contains several integrated circuits. The computer has a central processing unit. Identify the bus that carries signals around the CPU to control the components. If we take a look at our von Neumann model, we know that this consists of our CPU and some sort of stored memory. The CPU and the memory are connected with what is called our system bus. We then segment our system bus into three different buses. We've got the control bus, we've got the data bus, and we've got the address bus. Within our CPU, we have a number of components. We have two major components, the ALU and the control unit. The ALU stands for the arithmetic and logic unit. We also have a number of special registers, which we'll cover in another video. The first question asks us to identify the bus that carries signals around the CPU to control the components. The answer is going to be one of the control bus, data bus, or address bus. In this case, it's going to be control bus, as we're sending control signals to each of these components. The next question asks us to identify the register built into the arithmetic and logic unit, the ALU. Within our ALU, we have what is called the general purpose register, which is also known as the accumulator. This can be abbreviated to ACC. The accumulator is a general purpose register, which stores a single value that can be used by the ALU whilst it's doing arithmetic calculations. So the answer here is going to be the accumulator. The next question says, four statements about a von Neumann model for a computer system are shown. Tick to show if each statement is true or false. So going through each of these, the first one says data and instructions are stored in the same memory units. When we speak about data and instructions, we're speaking about programs. Programs contain data and the instructions which operate upon that data. The CPU is going to access those instructions and that data from the program, which is stored in our main memory. Both data and instructions are going to be stored within our memory, so the answer is true. The next statement says the control unit manages operations within the CPU. One of the functions of the control unit is to send control signals to all of the components within the CPU and outside the CPU. For example, a control signal could be to tell the ALU to perform a calculation. So the answer here is true. The next statement says data and instructions can be fetched into the CPU at the same time. Data and instructions are two separate things. When we're performing what's known as the fetch, decode, execute cycle, the processor can fetch a single data item. So we cannot fetch multiple data items within a single fetch, decode, execute cycle. So in this case, the answer is false. Keep in mind that we're speaking about the von Neumann model and we're not taking into account any multiprocessing. The last statement says that the control unit is responsible for decoding an instruction. If we look at the fetch, decode, execute cycle, the decode part of the cycle is after the fetch cycle. Once the instruction has been fetched from the memory, it gets stored in the current instruction register and is then accessed by the control unit to decode the instruction. So the answer is true. And there we go. That is this question complete.